south here, off the road and down this slope. We've got a decent trek ahead of us. Watch it. These pools don't just sink. They'll take a toe off.
Ugh. This is why I prefer spaceships and clean recycled air.
Thank you.
Fallbrook's on the other side of the bridge there if you need a drink. We're only halfway to the mountain, so might consider stopping in.
Trouble checking in? Or you might need directions to the amenities? If you're locked out of your cabin, a replacement key costs 50 bits. No reservation, no problem. Day trippers are always welcome in our saloon. Straight back and to the right. If you hit the falls, you've gone too far. Check in with Ms. Malin. She'll set you straight. I am here to anticipate and facilitate your needs, patron. Guess it's true. Fallbrook really is the best-kept secret in all of Monarch, excepting the Borst Factory's secret ingredient. We're a leisurely stopover for the more adventurous spacefaring traveler. Understand? Swell. We like quick on the draw types like you. Saloon is straight back and to the right. Once you're feeling sated, you're welcome to a private cabin. Only $2.50 a night. Ms. Malin can let you one if you're interested. She's the one who runs this racket.
Sublight territory feels like being home.
Fallbrook's great. Anything you want, they've got it. So long as you've got the bits.
Take a gander at that mug. I ain't ever seen someone so adept-looking my whole life.
He means gullible, Captain.
Watch yourself, Captain. This guy's got eyes like a sprat set on stealing your dinner.
Oh, now, come on. All I mean is, well, rather that, you don't seem like the usual pigeons we pluck. No offense, of course, if you are a Byzantium Goldblood. Say, I'd like to do you a favor. Might I interest you in a surefire scheme? Wink, wink. It's no flattery when it's true. Pure and simple, it's like this. I run our drug delivery service. Recently, I had the genius idea to cut costs in half by swapping our autoloaders with faster, cheaper sprats. See? I know a fellow genius when I clap eyes on him. Too right you are. Only problem is my sprat carriers ain't arrived from their latest run. As I was saying, you look more capable than most of the hoople heads around these parts. What say you locate him and retrieve the goods for me? In return, I'll cut you 5% of the profit. Hit me. I won't even hit back. Officially, I keep the books for Miss Malin, provide loans to the Byzantium Goldbloods for gaming, and oversee our drug running operations. Speaking of, might I interest you in a purchase? I'll give you a first-time discount. That's 5% off and a free drink at the ante up. You're welcome. Suit yourself. I run my sprat carriers back and forth through the shipping tunnels near the waterfall. Ought to check there first. Good luck. And don't get any ideas about pilfering the drugs for yourself. Was that sarcasm? I'm going to assume it was not. If it's sarcasm, you've got to show it somehow, like, with a wink. My sprat carriers scurry back and forth through the shipping tunnels. Any trail ought to start there. When you've got the goods, I'll be here.
Oh, I beg your pardon. Can you not see I'm walking here? Physically, you mean? In my mind, I have traveled galaxies. Well, it is of no consequence, I assure you. I shall embark shortly with my legs. I'm not entirely decided. If I'm being honest, I think I'd fancy a visit to Tartarus. So long as it's under the shield of my fantastical imagination.
You seen Arthur today?
Nah, last time I saw him was, stars, I can't remember. Days.
You don't think he got crushed during the bridge collapse?
It was his team running that drop? Sure puts things into perspective.
No refunds, no exchanges, no returns. And no whining about it either. If you bloody it, you buy it. Store policy. Yeah, and? Do I look like the city planner? I wasn't exactly consulted on the blueprints when Catherine started building out Fallbrook. But now that you mention it, I reckon she had her reasons to hide us. We got smugglers, outlaws, mavericks, and Byzantium socialites flying in and out of Fallbrook all the time. Why openly spit in the board's eye? It might be that you're right. But I got no reason to trust you with the truth, now do I? Maybe if you were a better friend to Sublight... Ask me again if you're standing with Sublight and proves, and I'll feel more obliged to answer.
My dry goods come 75% guaranteed mold-free. Or was that 75% mold-free? No rubbernecking. Make a buy or move on.
Uh-huh. You blind, fella? Or can you not see I'm busy? Why is it every sissy pig fucker who strolls into my town expects me to smile and shout awful friendly, "Welcome to Fallbrook"? Only nugget of paradise in this entire law-forsaken land, like a void damn advert.
Catherine, you're as welcoming as ever.
Truthfully spoken. I do aim to properly represent my aforementioned nugget of paradise. You know, I ain't heard that one before. Suppose I'll have to work harder to show you just what makes our town shine. But first, I'll need to know what brings you, stranger. Well, I'm half listening. Might be I know something about it. Might be someone hired my crew to blind drop supplies on the Northern Bridge. Might be they sure as shit weren't pirates. Now that I consider it, I ain't heard from my delivery team in far too long. Find them for me, and I'll pay you handsome. And I'll thank you kindly for it. If it's one that don't mind getting dirty, then I sure do. But how am I to know whether you're reliable, if not fully trustworthy? I do admire blunt honesty, so I'm willing to give a business arrangement between us a try. There's a Borst factory on up the way, run by a man who calls himself the King. Clive Lundberg, insufferable prick. That aside, it's a business ripe for the plucking. I want it. Clear as that. Stars, I hope so. Clive Lundberg, the self-proclaimed Borst King of Monarch, is swimming in profit and drowning in his ego. He's making the only meal to be had this side of Monarch, and I'm tired of ponying up for my dinner. I want that Borst factory, owner dead or alive. And you're the soon-to-be handsomely paid son of a bitch who's gonna get it for me. Kill him, run him out. I don't rightly care for the details, so long as Clive knows resistance to me is costly and futile. Hit him where it hurts. In his gut or his production lines ought to make do. Then I'd say you might care to poison the cysty pigs, doctor a few financial records, or throw a wrench in the canning machinery. It'll be more than good when you've finished. Maybe not for Clive, but for me and you, I'm sure. Oh, and if you don't fancy going in guns blazing or crawling through a sewer pipe, see Duncan in the dry goods and sundry building. He ought to have an employee ID in that stash of illicit goods he keeps for select clientele. May luck be with you, since I won't be.
Now there's a woman who knows what she wants. I like her. She's fine. Well, so long as you ain't on her bad side. Then she's liable to drown you in the waterfall.
Hungry? I'm famished myself. No rubbernecking. Make a buy or move on. Not so fast. The biometric IDs are special goods, only on offer to special clients. You cotton? She needs it for a job? Well, why didn't you say so? Reckoned you asked her where to best procure one, and she obligingly pointed you my way. Give me a jiffy to break. I mean, calibrate the ID. This goes like that. Nope, not quite right. A bit to the left, mayhaps. That'll do it. For a CMP factory line worker, she sure is a beauty. Careful. I'm trusting you to guard this specialty good with your life. I mean it. Lose the ID and you don't get another. Also, you'll be off my list of unwholesome customers. Will that be all, or do you require something to, say, scratch your itch?
always imagined Fallbrook would be...
cleaner, fancier, stocked with better booze.
Cheaper. I've emptied 14 good parts in the last 2 hours.
That's because you've got a terrible tell. Whenever you're lying, you might lie just like that.
I had a patient who went swimming at a place like this. Got eaten from the inside out by parasitic amoebas.
Thank you.
Yes. Knock, knock.
Go away, White.
Did you find them? Tell me you found my my Sprat carriers. Would hate should anything dire have befallen them. Just tell me straight, don't hold back. I can handle it. Sprat can always be replaced. Excellent. Oh, this is per... This is only half! Are you... You think you can steal from me? Search Fallbrook. Either half the Sprats got loose on their own, or there'll be some evidence pointing to the soon-to-be-dead snake who filched my carriers. You want your cut? You get me the rest of my drugs. No matter what it takes.
Mini-Malin, get your twitchy whiskers back here! Don't you run out that door! It's a cruel world outside! Close the damn door! You'll let my sprats out! Damn it all! Now look what you've done! It'll take me ages to round him up again! State your purpose, or get out of my face, domicile intruder! Missing? Nope. Nope. Mine are all found and accounted for, thank you kindly. Now if that'll be all... I've got an animal rescue service to oversee, and it ain't easy. Lots to do. Got a multitude of sprats to spay and feed. Look, I don't care if Nilsson sent you or not. You won't be hurting a hair on any of these Sprats' heads. I've killed vicious beasts for them. I ain't afraid to take on a human. Back out of this domicile, hands up, or become Sprat food, intruder. You want to dig through Sprat droppings? Be my guest. Get your drugs, then get lost. Thank you.
Got the goods? Because I know you wouldn't be wasting my time otherwise. Wink. Hit me. I won't even hit back. Miss Catherine Malin is one tough lady. Show her a bit of backbone, and I swear she'll like you more for it. Pure and simple, it's like this. I run our drug delivery service. Recently, I had the genius idea to cut costs in half by swapping our autoloaders with faster, cheaper sprats. Only problem is my sprat carriers ain't arrived from their latest run. You're retrieving the lost goods from me. In return, I'm paying you a percent of the profit. Sure it is. Wink. You do? I mean, you do! Of course you do! What did I tell you? Sure Fire Delivery System. Works almost every time. Right, right. In my excitement, I very nearly forgot. Ha ha. As promised, you're cut. Plus a little extra to show my gratitude. Now, if there's nothing else you need from me, I must go inventory my goods. Thank you.
Hello there. A word, if I may be so bold? Well now, here I thought those mantisaurs had peacefully exited the premises. But you're a simpler explanation. Thanks for the assistance. Name's Weston. Every once in a while, I set up shop along these here roads. You find yourself in need of resupply, you come on by. Care to purchase a thing or two?
Take my reputation on this being an ambush.
Bunch of amateurs. Sublight should have seen this coming.
Thank you.
Stay back. I may be wounded, but I'm still armed. How'd you get past my traps anyway? Hiding from the marauders that hit us, obviously. Now your turn. That feels a mite better. Wish I had something to give you, but I gnawed through my last spratwurst an hour ago. Nice to know she cares. Catherine had us making drops for some big-shot client out here. And before you ask, I don't know who they are. Or were. The whole point of making drops in the middle of nowhere was to keep their identity and whereabouts a secret. The Marauders knew we were coming. Rigged the bridge with explosives and everything. If they found us, my guess is they found the client too. Last I saw, they were heading back up the hill. You'll see it on the right when you get out of here. If you've got the sand to go after him, I'm sure Catherine can reward you for your trouble. Me? I'm headed back to Fallbrook, just as soon as I've caught my breath.
Hell of a job. They'll never see us.
What a...
I didn't mean what I said about your outfit. It's very fashionable, I swear.
Oh, I'd be to see that again.
Thank you.
another fight in me.